Hello, lovely people. I will explain from A to Z the use it, don't lose it method, the sublimation, bringing the energy up method, what is also similar method described in the sexual Tao as a microcosmic orbit. So I will use this drawing. So this is a level of ecstasy, what it also corresponds to level of energy. And here is the time. And I will explain the differences between the typical sex and tantric love. So here we will draw the typical sex. So in the typical sex, the man is so keen to start the penetration that for him the foreplay doesn't have to exist, but he does it because he read in some sexual books that the woman needs it. So he does it less than 10 minutes, and then during the penetration, excitements go quickly up, and then he reached the point of no return and he have ejaculatory orgasm, and everything we will describe soon in the all details. And here we have more one of the way of tantric love making. Okay, now everything in more details. Yes, so as I said, in typical sex, the man goes very quickly to penetration, they go for a little bit of the foreplay, but it's usually too little that the woman will feel ready, and especially her yoni will feel ready and open and juicy and wet, and that have consequences. And when the penetration starts, in average, within 7 minutes of penetration, he reaches the so-called point of no return. And what happens next? Usually my students, they get the right answer because it's very typical. He's saying he's having the ejaculatory orgasm, and then he loses so much energy that he is usually saying, "Hey darling, I love you so much, but now I have to go to sleep." And before she answers, he is already turning his back to her and snoring. And so yes, so now I will explain more in details the more one of the way of tantric love making and all the benefits and all the methods and golden advice on the way, and use it, don't lose it method, of course, I will explain in detail. So first of all, what we can do in tantric love making and that already will bring great benefits for the woman, for the man, for their ecstasy and love level. And I believe if more people would get educated about this advice, then we would change the humanity. So when we allow the woman to decide when the foreplay should turn into the penetration, so she get enough foreplay, she enough get her yoni get ready, she feel respected, honored, given enough time, and yes, in that way it have a beautiful healing effect on the yoni, on the woman, that the yoni instead of pain when she was not ready, and basically force into insertion when she was dry and it was painful to her. Instead of that, she got great experience that she was respected, her time was honored, and so. So instead of a bit of traumatizing, what actually is the main cause of the sexual trauma for the woman, the forced insertion when her yoni was not ready, that would make her not connected with her sexuality, so blocked from her sexuality. So when we give the woman enough foreplay, we heal that. We establish the new experience to her, what says to her, hey, sexuality can be nice, can be beautiful, she can be respected in it, her time could be honored, and she doesn't have to be afraid that she will be hurt again. Between her body, between her yoni and the brain, is established new neurotic path, and as more it happened into her life, the more willing, more satisfaction, more the woman like more sexuality, and she stopped saying every time when you mention darling, let's go to bed, she's saying, oh, I have headache today. Yes, she would ask you actually, darling, let's go to bed herself, if you keep her giving enough foreplay. So I believe really that if more people would get educated about that small golden advice, the world will become a better place. So I always ask all of you brothers who are watching this video, always be a healer. Give the woman enough foreplay. And all the sisters who are watching this video, always demand from the man enough foreplay. It would be also beneficial for his ecstasy levels and growing further. His experience would be much nicer. And yes, you don't need special skills for this. You just have to dedicate yourself for more enjoyment, and that's it. Yes? So, when the woman decides about penetration, again, excitement goes quickly up during the intercourse, but this time, before the point of no return, we do the use it, don't lose it method. So, we bring the energy up instead of losing it. So with the breathing, we tight the PC muscle and we visualize that the energy goes up to the heart, and then when we relax the PC muscle, we breathe out and we visualize that the energy goes down. So we use the three parts in this method, which are interconnected and they are used in the same time. So one is visualization, the other is PC muscle, and the other is breath. So now more in the details. PC muscle is the muscle what we use to stop urinating. So the best way how to recognize this muscle is whenever you go, next time it's your homework, yes? When you go to the toilet, when you pee, force yourself to stop peeing and recognize which muscles are you using. Do it few times that you are sure which muscles are you using and which muscles you don't have to use, yes? So recognize clearly what are the PC muscles, and then you can start training. And this is another golden advice what I would like to give you. I can bet with you for any price that when you will train your PC muscles and you will just for 5 minutes daily for 1 month, that even if you will lose the bed, you will be still very thankful for getting that advice, because this will improve your life on many levels, not only on the sexual level, what we explain here, but also they used tightening the PC muscle in yoga, in Tai Chi, in Qigong, for the same reason, to keep the energy up, to not to lose the energy. It really works very good for your self-esteem, for your strong will power. It helps you on your relationship level, on loving yourself. It helps you a lot in your health issues, especially around the genitals, around this area, also the belly. Many brothers, when they get older, they get the beer belly, so-called beer belly. And it's not only the beer the reason, but the main reason actually of it is weak PC muscle. Because when you have strong PC muscle, it holds even the big belly in the shape, not like soaking and overfloating from your trousers, but really keep it in the shape. So yes, it's like base muscles, yes? So, and many others benefits you have from training the PC muscles, the health benefits, but also the mental benefits. So yes, training it doesn't cost you nothing. I'm doing it all the time. While I'm talking to you, you don't see that I'm doing it. I can still talk to you, and so it doesn't cost me any attention. I can do it in any circumstances, when I watch the movie, when I wait for the tram, when I even cycle on the bike, when I brush my teeth, then I remember to do it twice, you know? And yes, you do it 3 times a day. You start like with all the muscles, you start maybe with 30 times a time, so and then you build up every day, you add 10 or 20, however you feel, till you have like 100 per time, so 3 times a day, altogether 300, so 3 times 100. It's less than 5 minutes altogether, but it gives you more benefits than any training of any muscles can give you. And as I said, we can bet about any price, and you will be happy. Even if you lose the bet for any price, you will still be happy about this advice. So check it. Don't believe me, just check it. So yes. So with the tightening the PC muscle, we shut the energy up. With the breath in, we suck the energy up. And with the breath, it's another thing what I will guide you into. The breath is like gas pedal in the our sexuality. When you are a beginner driver, you don't press the gas pedal so much. You drive slowly, you drive safe, yes? So the same with the lovemaking, with our sexuality, also during the tantric massage, during the self-love pleasuring, you breathe slowly, that you are more in control, yes? That the energy spreads all over the body, it doesn't stay accumulated here, yes? So, the same with the movement. When you move slowly, you are on the slow speed, you are more in control. You can notice when you are closer to the point of no return, your breath is becoming shallow and your movement is also like fast and shallow. It's like, so by slowing down your breath, you not only influence slowing down your pain, your sadness, your anger, but also you may influence your excitement. So you just slow your breath, and if you like to be safe, you stay on the slow breath. So that's it's very good to know about. So then we have a visualization, the next component. So they say that the energy follows attention. That's why we visualize. You can visualize how you like it, as a green ball, as a stream of light, as a some smoke, as a stream of water, however you like. So with the breathing, you visualize that you tighten your PC muscle and it goes on your spine, to your heart, and with the breath out, you relax the PC muscle and it goes back to your genitals. So that helps the energy flow. So, yes, before the point of no return, we do 5, maybe 7 of those circles. And thankful that this too much energy, what was ready to explode and get lost during the peak orgasm, we brought all to the heart. So we are more connected within ourselves, we are more loving ourselves, and we are more connected with our partner, with loving our partner. So the quality of our lovemaking, it's increased while we still have energy to continue with the penetration. Yes? So only the energy, ecstasy here was brought here, so it's less. So we can continue with the penetration after 5 or 7 of those circles. If you do too much, then yes, you may get soft, so you don't usually want that. It's no problem in Tantra, but especially at the beginning, you want to keep your energy. So yes, don't do it too much. That's why I'm saying you have to feel yourself, maybe 5, maybe 7, maybe 4. It depends also from your days. So yes, after all these circles, you feel, okay, I'm far away from the point of no return. That's the main point. You're far away from the point of no return, so we can continue with penetration. And yes, again, before the point of no return, better too early than too late, you do the use it, don't lose it method. Yes? And you can see that after 2 or 3 times stopping and doing those circles, you are already on much higher ecstasy than in typical sex. And you can continue as you like. You may continue, the time is passing by, what make your woman very happy about that, what make you happy about that, of course, you want to satisfy your lover. So, and then it goes up and up and up, and it goes further and further and further, and as much as you wish. And you in Tantra, we don't lose this energy, we don't end up with the ejaculation towards the end, because then you stay attached to the ejaculation attachment and addiction, and then you will lose the energy, and that's not the point of the Tantra. So yes, but you decide whenever you feel enough ecstasy, you decide yourself, and this makes big difference. So now I will explain how this big difference make that this sexual aspects of Tantra make it one of the most powerful spiritual practice, and one of the main thing would change your life, your love, and your spirituality much higher. So step by step. So in typical sex, we are cut off from the best moment of the experience without us having any control. So that's why we want to repeat it again. We wish to have it longer, so we want to repeat it again, and we're choosing for the sex, especially the men. So we want harder penetration, harder experience, more kinky, to have higher peak and longer peak. So yes, but we actually do it always is cut off in the best moments. So we are never satisfied. In tantric lovemaking, we are the one who decide when we want to finish. So we have enough. We are satisfied. We are fulfilled. And when we are free from the after 21 day challenge, we free from the attachment to ejaculation. Then you know we are satisfied. We don't crave. Yes, for the we don't want even the ejaculation to happen because we don't want game over and we don't want to lose energy. We don't want to stay driving on sex and on sex desires. So. Imagine, I always say example, imagine that I have one delicious organic, tantric, shamanic, fair trade from the South America, from the best shamans, raw chocolate. It tastes so good. It's like heaven in your mouth, yes? And yes, I share it with you. You got a piece, I got a piece, and it's almost over. The last piece is standing, it's, lying in the middle, and we keep talking and so. But it was so good that it takes your attention. You feel like, I wish to. Shall I take this last piece, or it would be impolite? And you, like, basically desire this last piece of chocolate because it was so good. Yes. So. Yes. Imagine another situation. I got for my birthday the package from my mom, full of the same chocolate, but all box. And I see that. Oh wow! You know, like it's organic. It's like. No preservatives and so it's expiry date, it's very soon, and I have all box, so yes. I give you three packages of this chocolate, and yes, we talk, we eat, you eat half of it, maybe you eat all package, and you're satisfied. You feel, wow, it was so good, the same good like before, but you eat so much that you're satisfied. It's enough. Two other boxes you put back, put in your home somewhere on the shelf, and you forget about it. For 1 week, you like you are not desiring. When you just got small piece, you could not concentrate anymore on what I'm talking because you were still desiring about it. So the same is with the sex. When you are not getting fulfilled and you are cut in the half of experience in the best moments, you keep running on desires. You keep chasing, you keep thinking, you are obsessed with the sexuality. You want to repeat the experience. You want to have it more and more and more. When you are satisfied, the love making, it's becoming your choice, not a need what you have to fulfill. It's your, like, you know that it's good to make love for you, for your partner, for the connection of the relationship and so, but you don't chase it. You are satisfied. You got so much, you got enough, you can have a bit more, but you don't have to. So. Yes, this brings a complete different perspective to the lovemaking and to the to your life. When you are satisfied in your sexuality, you it all starts from your root chakras. If it flows here, it also will be more easy to flow here in the heart. So when you are satisfied in your sexuality, there is more tendency that you will be satisfied in your loving yourself and in loving your partner and in your relationship. You would be more keen to be satisfied in your creativity, in your self-esteem. So yes, all starts from here. And it gives you the freedom, yes? Freedom from the desires, yes? It's that's the freedom what all the spirituality is talking about, yes? That you don't chase the desire for sex. You do it out of choice. Like, you know, people who do yoga, for example. There, I don't know if there are some people who they have to do yoga. They do it because they know it's good for them. It's, they will feel good. They will be more efficient in their work, in their life. They know the benefits of yoga. The same with tantric lovemaking. You don't do it because you have to do it. You do it because it's a beautiful gift for yourself, and it's a beautiful gift for your woman. We call it sacred sexuality tantric lovemaking. It's a one of the most beautiful, most intimate, most close, most powerful, energizing expression of more and more unconditional love. Love to yourself, love to your partner, love it to all. Yes? So, but we go further with that. Yes? So, this tantric lovemaking, it may bring you to one of the highest experiences what I ever experienced in my life. Cosmic orgasm, universal orgasm. It's not that I felt all the cells in my body, I felt connected, I felt wholeness within my being. I felt oneness even more with, I felt oneness with my partner. I felt like we are one beautiful sacred union. Yes, and that's amazing, that's beautiful. But further on, I felt what it's called in many spiritual teachings as a nirvana samadhi, that you feel this oneness with all. There is no separation anymore. So this beautiful slogan, what many teachings, what many religions are sharing, that we are all one, Tantra gives you as a real experience. And when you experience something, when it's not just some belief, then you know, then it would be silly for me to hurt someone, because someone's pain, someone's sadness, it feels like my sadness. As more you are connected within yourself, as more you are in Tantra, that you are becoming more empathic. And the same thing about the happiness, you know, like very often, yes, that's one beautiful moment during my workshops. That's kind of my best payoff, you know, when I not only hear your words in the sharing circle, that, hey, that was beautiful experience, it lifted me up, and so I feel much better. But I see your glowing face, I see your happiness, I see your liberation in your eyes, and like your growth, and so, believe me, your happiness is my happiness. So when you know that, and you know it from experience, that we are all one, it would be silly to harm someone. That's why I choose to share love, because I want to see more happiness in around in people's eyes, because their happiness is my happiness. We are all one. I know it. So because I know it, I don't see a better choice of living life than sharing love and educate others about that as a better path for me. Yes. So, yes. This beautiful. I can give you some advice how you can experience this beautiful cosmic universal orgasm. So when you free yourself from the ejaculation and you are making love in the tantric way, and you really love with all your passion the person who you are connected with, that may, I wish you may experience it. And you experience it once, at least once, you know, like, and that would be enough because you will know it. So I wish you, yes, follow that tantric path and you will have that beautiful experience, what will empower you for and till the end of your life, because you know it. You will not have to believe in this anymore. So yes, but there is another experience what it's even more beautiful, and what you can repeat it as many times as you like, and that's for me it's most beautiful experience what I can have in my life, and I'm happy that I can guide you into it, and I can have it. So seeing the happiness in my beloved eyes after lovemaking, usually that's the most moments when it happens. Seeing happiness, satisfaction, gratitude in my beloved eyes, and knowing that I influence that happiness, it's like the heaven for me. This is one of the most beautiful moments in my life. And I'm very blessed to have it a lot. And, you know, that's why I bless the relationship with Trish. And I'm very happy about that. So, yes, for the contrary, the worst hell what may happen is like to see sadness, disappointment, in your beloved eyes, and knowing that you influence that. However, maybe it came from unawareness or whatever, it's the biggest hell what you can experience in your life. So you don't want to repeat this anymore, this mistake, or yes, this, you learn from it, yes? So. Yes, in that way I wanted to show you how Tantra, from the sexual aspects, it guides you into very spiritual aspects, that you want to do good things, you want to see happiness in especially your beloved eyes, and yes, you don't want to disappoint them, you don't want to harm them, and yes, see the sadness in their eyes. So that's from the sexual aspects, how, like, use it, don't lose it method, we can grow together as individuals and as a humanity into a better world for us and for our beloved ones and for all. Yes, so that's how it makes Tantra very spiritual practice for me. Yes, so I wish you get so much happiness that I do and I share. I wish it worked for you better than even for me. But yeah, if it worked in the same, I'm happy for you and for all people around, what you will spread this energy around. Thank you for your attention.